another thing. The role of a military anywhere is their loyalty should not be any president. Their loyalty should be to the Kenyan people, to the state. For instance, in Kenya, we have very brutal, corrupt, unpatriotic generals. For instance, National Security Intelligence of Kenya is sleeping on their job. They failed to advise President Kibaki in the right manner. They failed in their duty to protect Kenya. Kenya has been involved twice by Osama Al-Qaeda and Kikabala bombings because the role of a military is not to torture their people, to break people's neck and limbs, is to protect Kenyan people. Gatia will be proud when that day will come, when an army, when Kenyan people can call armed forces, these are people's soldiers, these are our soldiers, because our soldiers, people's soldiers, we will not maim them, we will not root, we will not shoot them on sight, but they will protect Kenyan people because that is their duty. And their loyalty should be to Kenyan people. The same case applies to Kenya police. Since independence, we have very brutal police force, paramilitary. During colonialism, GSU is a continuation of what during colonialism we used to call them heka heka battalions. Thigalichia kale gale goni kule gale gia vava na mami. Naga wa Kenya. This is what we call GSU to do. Home guards as Kalikanga, the most brutal to this day. And again, I want to prove to Kenyan people that for a president, any president, now and in the future, promoting military officers, police officers, intelligent officers from your tribe cannot protect people. For instance, I don't give a very good analysis or picture during elections in Kenya. That is December 2007 and January. These brutal military and patriotic generals, this is being led by Gichanga, General Gichanga, Kianga leading army, Mathew Itele leading the paramilitary GSU, Kinuthia leading these APs, tribal police, formerly tribal police, could not protect even Kikuyus and the people. That when a president like Kenyatta, Kibaki, Moi have been doing during their leadership is to promote their tribes in the police force, in the armed forces, in all military wings or units in that country. But this is rubbish because during elections that we had 2007, December and January, we saw military being led by Kikuyu chauvinists and the corrupt generals and unpatriotic, cannot defend their own people because the paramilitary could, under the leadership of Matele, Matthew, Amiru, Agema, GS, the leader, the commandant of GSU, the missus, National Security Intelligence under Brigadier Gichangi, General Kianga, Amkamba, Kikuyu cousins, could not save. And the administration of police, Buthia, could not save Kikuyus from being burned in churches. They are killed in Eldoret. being affected. They couldn't stop people being affected, allowed, speared, burned, their cattle destroyed, their farms destroyed, their houses burnt, their houses occupied, even Nairobi, Kibera, Mathale, everywhere, Kariobangi, Hawaii, and they are Kikuyu, Mudoakwa. Why there was no Mudoakwa? Why did the Kikuyu sleep at the Ngorosa the way Bishop tells them? We saw. We are very bitter to this day. And that's why we are calling for criminals who ever participated to be dealt with. Kenyan soldiers has been living in tents. Prison warders has been living worse than the prisoners themselves in Hovio, because we have only generals whom, when they meet the president, they just salute him and they don't air the soldiers' rights. The common soldier lives in hovels. Police the same. They live in tents. Their salaries. There is discrimination even within the armed forces itself. I know when we fight, we talk of democracy. Even the armed forces that protects Kibaki and his government live in isolation. They are not living in democracy. They are part and parcel of the Kenyan community. And when we talk of liberation, we don't want to leave anybody outside. If you are a policeman, think, because our problem is lack of thinking. If you are ordered to shoot and kill your people, say no. I will give an example. In Spain, they have ethnic guerrillas, but we don't hear Spain shooting them. But they are arresting them. The law. We cannot allow a police who are judges, magistrates, prosecutors, and executioners. Tell me in the country, and I challenge Kenya journalists to come with a list of how many Kenyan people that are shot on sight since this General Ali was handpicked from the military to lead the police. This general has killed so many Kenyan youth, and this must stop. We cannot accept. Because if we arrest all these generals, these corrupt generals, and take them to court, in fact, they don't have anything to protect them, to defend themselves, because all generals, we have seen that, we know, they always say, sir, I was taking orders. It is a crime to take rubbish orders from a president, because the role of the military is to advise the president when he goes wrong. And I have said this even before. To caution the president must be also listened. His telephone must be also taped, because perhaps he's a traitor. How do you know he's a sellout? The security of Kenya is bigger than the president itself. So that's why we say even the nieces need democracy. CID, special forces, anybody needs democracy. Not in the nepotism. Because Kenya is bigger than this general corrupt. These corrupt generals. And I appeal, if I was Kibaki, these generals who failed to protect Kenyans should not be in work. They should have been fired. I can't see any reason, or there is no any justification why these generals cannot be fired without honor. But what we have Kibaki doing is to give them burning spears. What is that? What's a humiliation to Kenyan people? Thank you.